In this tutorial, we will see how we can import an object in My AR Studio to visualize it in augmented reality. So the first thing we need to do is have an object to import. And in this video, we're gonna export from Cinema 4D and then import in My AR website and then visualize it with our smartphone. So we're gonna start with Cinema 4D. And to make this really easy, we can get an object from the asset browser. If we click up here on the left side and we navigate into this panel, and let's get into the packaging folder where we can find products. Now the packaging folder is in the models folder, and then down here packaging. You can also pick other objects, but I'm gonna go for a specific object that I have selected, which is this box apple juice. Now you can click and drag this inside, but this will position the object in a specific point into the grid. So it's probably better to double click, because this is gonna bring it in the exact origin of the axis, so in the exact center of the world. This is better, and it's really important when we work with augmented reality apps, so that the object is going to be exactly in the center also of your visualization. So we can also modify the position using the transform tools. We can move it, we can rotate it, we can also scale it. Now, another important thing is that the object is in the correct size. So if we want to check on that, we can go into Window and go into the Coordinate Manager, or Shift plus F7. And this will tell me down here the dimensions. Now let's click here on Size Plus. And you can see that this is the height on the epsilon axis, which is about 22 centimeters. This is the width on the x axis, which is about 7 centimeters. And this is the depth, which is on the z axis, and it's about 6 centimeters. We can also undock this and position this panel wherever we want. So we can customize the Cinema 4D interface. Now, another possibility I have is to create a box. So if I go to create menu, mesh, and then go to cube, and then if I go here, I can see the actual object properties and the object dimensions. So I can use this to compare it with my object and see if everything is fine. I can also keep this object if I want, but in this case, I will delete it with the delete key. Now we can build really complex scenes by assembling the scene with different objects. But in this case, I'm only gonna use one. Also, keep an eye on how big is your scene and how heavy it is. Now, to explore the scene and to see how many polygons we have and how big are the textures, which are going to define the heaviness of the scene, we can use a couple of tools. Now, if I click on the scene, I can right click and then go into object information or scene information. This will tell me how many polygons I have. Also, I can click here on this group and then right click and go in the object information and scene information from here. Now, this is now about 4,000 polygons. The suggested amount will be around 100,000 polygons. Now remember that you need to upload and then download and visualize this using your smartphone. So you probably don't want to exaggerate with the heaviness of the scene. You can see here the file size. So if I want to increase a little bit the quality, and also I want to increase the polygons and the material and the texture quality, I need to work on this scene. Now, if we expand on the right side, the hierarchy of the elements that are in this particular scene, we can see that this is composed by three different meshes for the cap and the carton. And then I have also subdivision generator applied to this mesh. Now, we don't have any subdivision at the moment, but I can increase the subdivisions down here in the subdivisions viewport. So this will be actually in here, not only in the renderer. Now, to visualize the polygons, I can go to display and choose something that contains lines, like constant shading lines, for example. And here I can see I can increase the complexity and the details, but also the number of polygons and the heaviness of the model and the scene. So if I increase this value, and again, right-click, go back to object information, or you can also press Ctrl-I. Now we can see that this is the amount that we now have. So it went from 4,000 to 27,000, just with a simple increase of the subdivision. So I'm gonna put this down because we don't really need that for this example. And again, if it's not necessary, it's better to keep the number of polygons down rather than really high. And also I'm gonna go back to display and go back to standard Guru shading. For the texture, we can go in the material editor, we can see the materials that have been used for this scene, and we can double click and explore the material and the textures. But in this video, we will not go into depth with this. So if you want, you can search for other videos in the platform. So I'm going to continue here and I'm going to export now. So I'm going to close everything we don't need and go to file, and I'm going to go in the export. And from this list, I'm going to search for GLTF/GLB. Now you don't want to click here. You want to click on this little engine icon. So I'm going to click here. And here from this panel, well, I can keep everything as it is, except for a couple of really important settings. Now, the first one here is file format. You need to make sure that this is not GLTF, but is GLB binary. You can also manage the scale from here if you want, if you need to adjust something, and if you didn't already in the scene. And then if we go down, we don't need animation right now, we can have a look here to the materials. Of course, we want textures if the object has textures, and then expand this, and this will be the resolution of the texture. Now, remember that the heaviness of the scene is about how big and complex is also the texture, not only the 3D model with the polygons. So you don't want to go too high with this. 1024 times 1024 will be fine. Otherwise, also 2048, we're going to keep this as it is, and we don't want to enlarge. You also have other options here. So down enlarge, press OK, and now you need to define a position for this, and this is going to be my folder. So I'm just going to call this Apple box and C4D. Save, and there you go. Now the object is exported. It's time to go in a browser and just type my AR Studio and get into the My AR Studio website. Now we can click here on Try Now on the top right, and we can start our trial. Now, what you need to do, you can see I already made an import, so I'm going to delete this one here. And what you need to do to access this private area the first time is create an account. So you need to register with your email, create a password, and then you can get into your space, which is basically the place where you're going to upload all your models, and then you can visualize them in augmented reality. So I'm going to click on the plus icon here. Now I can either drag and drop the file from the folder into this space, or I can just click with my mouse and then select the 3D model I want. Now I want this one here that I've just exported. I can also see a preview if I have installed the 3D visualizer for Windows, and it seems to be fine. So I'm gonna press open, and there you go. Now it's inside my cloud in my AR studio. Now, if I want to take a snapshot of this, I can define a point of view and then go here and click on this icon here. And then I can generate the poster. Well, actually, I can still orbit around if I want a little bit. And then when I'm happy, I can click on generate poster, and this will generate this that I can use later for visualizing my project. And when I'm finished, I can click again and exit the Polaroid mode. Now, you can also check here on this little icon the dimensions of this object. So this will be the actual dimensions displayed on the augmented reality when I will use my camera of my smartphone. And these are other panels if you want to explore. And down here, you also have export options, but we will not talk about this in this video. If you want, you can also check the documentation. You find the little button here on the left side. So all I'm going to do here is just save and publish. You can see now it's converting it, preparing the file for augmented reality. Now I'm going to make this browser a little bit smaller, and also I'm going to make some space here in the screen so I can open up an application where you can visualize my smartphone. So with this little button down here on the bottom right, we can click and we can get the QR code. And now we need to scan this with our smartphone. Now you can see here on the left a visualization of my smartphone screen. So all I need to do is go in the camera, and I'm going to use the scanner up here. So I'm going to click, or you can use any other app if you want. I'm going to scan that, and you can see it's going automatically into my RStudio. Now the final step. Again, here on the bottom right of this visualization on the smartphone, I can click on the little AR button. This time you will see through your camera of the smartphone, and then you can see the objects is placed on that space, on that table. So move the smartphone around a little bit and try to scan a little bit the surroundings and the scene where you want to place it. It's necessary to place it on a flat surface like a table or something similar. You can move your finger around to move the object. You can spin two fingers clockwise or counterclockwise to make it rotate. And if you want to resize it, you just need to spread your fingers or bring them closer. So you can basically investigate your object. Now let's get back in our space in my AR Studio website. I can go always back and check all my products and all my works, and I can come back inside and I can again click and generate a QR code. I can use this on any device. I can also share my work using the universal viewer. You have here a little link icon, so if you copy this, you can paste it. You can also click on the button. You can copy and paste it in any social network. You can send it via mail. You can also embed a code into your website. Thank you for watching this video tutorial, and I remind you to subscribe to the channel so to stay updated and to follow on any news. And please check also our other videos for more information about my AR Studio.